What's up, guys? Welcome back. It's more Long Dark. So we left off. We're getting ready to head out. I already done 8. We just need to pick up all of our stuff over here. We are carrying quite a bit. Alright. It's all good, though. When we get back home, we're going to fix our clothing and stuff. Alright, we're pretty heavy. Let's see here. What else can I downsize? We've got just our clothing on. We have a truckload of food. And I have to leave behind, like, some stuff. Finny, come on, buddy. No, I don't want to hold it. Hold on. Go on, Finn. He's like, you're at your desk, you want to hold Kitty? And I'm like, no. Don't want to hold Kitty. Jeez, look at all this bear meat. We'll have to leave it and come back for it maybe another time. I got all this airplane food too, which is crazy. We gotta pick up this. Leave the lantern. It's all that stuff. Let me leave behind. We have a lot of charcoal as well. I use the charcoal pretty quickly though. Drop the can. Drop the torch. Alright, I think everything else is going to have to come with us. Alright, we're going to be a little heavy, but that's okay. I always get paranoid, you know? I'm like, did I leave anything? It's like, no, you're good. Just relax. Okay. I'll try. About to get shot, bro. You'll make it. He's like heading towards me this way, and then I just try to cut over, and he decides, he's like, well, I'll just cut over in front of you. It's a good way to get shot in the face hole. He's gonna get shot. Alright, guy. Bugging me, dude. Alright, you know what? Some of this charcoal's gonna have to go. Like 10. We can always get more charcoal. Alright, we're slow again, but we know where we're going. Not. going that way. Going our separate ways, pal. Yeah, so I think that this road is going to wrap around and go all the way down back by that barn. I think there might be a town in between here and there. We'll just have to go check. Every ridge I see that like looks like that, it looks like you can get up on it fairly easy. I'm like, did they have a bunker up there? But I really, outside of the ones along the river with the waterfall, like I don't know where the other bunker locations are, or if they've moved them since I played way back in the day. Like it has been a hot minute. I don't know if I've played this game for 4 or 5 years. I've been busy, man. Like, life happened. I moved around a lot. I was living in the camper for a while. Met a new girl. Got involved with her. We bought a house together. Like, friggin' life happened. When I look back, I'm like, man, does all that time really go by? It's like, yeah, it flew by. It didn't feel like it at the time, but when I look back, like, every year of my life was like, there was so much stuff and just packed a little bit in 1 year. I hope that after, like, after you die, you get to do like a rewind, you know, watch it all back again, like your own movie, your own DVR, where you can fast forward, rewind, just like, oh, what happened in this year? What did I do? You'd be like, oh yeah, I remember that. That was good stuff. That would be awesome. I would not mind that at all. Re-experience all the delicious meals you ate, all the fun times you had. That would be mucho bueno. Very good, man. Birds just let me know there's a dead dude over there. I'm like, yeah, I know. He dead. What happened to him? Oh, he died. Surprisingly enough, they always die outside of, like, a vehicle. I know if, like, I was freezing to death, I'd at least freeze to death inside the vehicle. I guess once hypothermia sets in, you start getting like hypoxia to your brain. You might act weird and do some weird stuff. I think our current president is suffering from that. Not hypothermia, probably hypoxia. Whatever it's called. You get like not a lot of oxygen to your brain. It's probably true. Which is sad. need to get back to that bridge. Once we get across the bridge, we'll be back in new territory. And it'll be more exciting. I get excited whenever I get to new places and find new stuff. Like that, that waterfall cave was cool. That was super awesome. Good. Fine. See, aside from, maybe, I think the bulletproof vest that I found in Black Rock, that might be the first, like, other hidden item I've found, is the storm lantern and probably this sweater. I can't remember finding too many more. I know there's other ones. They were supposed to hide a bunch in the airfield, but whenever I explored the airfield, I didn't find nothing. Of course, I was way undergeared for the airfield as well, because I just spawned right outside of it, and then I went in hoping that I would find all my basic stuff, and it didn't even give me a knife or an axe. And this game without a knife or an axe is rough. You are forever just picking up sticks. You're like, oh god, a stick. And another stick, and another stick. I'd be carrying like 40, 50 sticks on me. Because you can't get firewood. You can't harvest meat off of frozen animals or anything. You have to basically, like, I had to light fires and just put them next to the corpse and wait for it to thaw. And then you could, harvest some meat off of them. But like, as far as hides and stuff go, I don't know if I can get hides or anything. You can get, like, meat. I know that. Some more birds going that way. If they stop right there, there might be a dead dude. They're still going. Trucking it that way. We're just going to keep following this road for now. Because we're not too far off the beaten path, you know. This road pretty much, I don't know. I think this is the edge of the map right here. So I don't know how much there can be. Through here, okay, there's something over there. It looks like maybe a cave. Go around here, just make sure that there's nothing. Well, this looks like it's just a giant hill, yeah. Okay. So there's a large hill. There's potentially, well, not potentially, there is something dead over there. Potentially a cave. Could just be a dead dude off the side of the road too, I suppose. Hey, tree. That tree is swaying. You hear it creak? Oh yeah, it looks like a cave. There's definitely a cave with a dead something. Might be a dead deer carcass. We're gonna check it out. Moving really slow, so I'll just like try to talk to you guys some more. Maybe we got a, I think it's a deer carcass. God, I don't even know if I can hold another pellet. I don't know if I want one, to be honest. Do I have on me? I've only got 4 good deer hides. Yeah, I think we're good. I don't need that. The only question is there anything in this cave? Whoa. looks like nothing. Okay. Yep. Whole lot of nada up in this cave. I think my guy's getting... pretty tired. Better eat and drink. Okay. That relieves a little bit of weight. I'm almost out of water, though. I'm going to have to boil water soon. So, if we were in like a blizzard or whatever, there would be a little cave where you could take refuge. Nothing wrong with that. We're gonna get back on the road though. I think you travel faster on the road. On the road again. Guess I could go ahead and survey real quick. Our way downtown. We need to get back to home base with all these pelts and stuff, and then we can do some crafting. I bet you all the stuff that we left at home is already cured. There's a lot of this stuff cured just when we were out here. To get this bear pelt cured, that way we can get a bear hide, a barrel, or whatever it is. I'm pretty sure it's way warmer than the standard sleep and roll. It probably just weighs more. That's mostly the trade-off of the gear. Like, the better the gear that you get, it's just like in real life, really. The better the gear that you want, the heavier it is. But of course, there isn't like any down stuff or anything in this game. It's all old school. It's like your bedroll is just like a wool blanket. I hear a lot of wolves. Luckily, they seem to be over that way. I do miss being able to move fast. Being able to really truck along is super convenient. But the downside of that is if you leave home without enough supplies, you could just die. Die of dehydration, die of starvation. Could get real bad, okay? But I really don't know where I am at the moment. I'm hoping to happen across something. I see some wolves over there. It might be a cave. Survey and see if any pops up. I don't see nothing. Oh wait, we got houses. I think those are the houses by that big bridge, yep. Okay. I remember this. And I think across the bridge is the small town. And then if we continue down this road, pretty sure we'll run back into that first barn that we went to whenever we climbed down from the radio tower. So once we spend a couple of days crafting some stuff, and polishing up our bear meat, we'll probably be ready to move on to Timberwolf Mountain. Timberwolf Mountain's a tough zone. So there's not a lot of man-made structures. You have to basically survive like in caves, and there are some fishing huts and stuff though. You can fish. You can do quite a few things. Derelict cabins. I'm gonna take that because I do need to boil water. Oh, this ain't the town, this is just some cabins. I thought these were the beginning of the... They might be further down. What's up there? Let's see. Okay, so this is just some derelict cabins. We might have to bunker down in one of these for the night. There's a hunting knife. We got another handbook. Might end up chilling here for the night, guys. Yep, found the derelict cabins. Okay. So, we didn't follow the river. The river dropped down, though. So, I don't know if it is possible to follow the river. Oh my god, this map is so huge. We're only here. Alright, let's start us a fire though. Oh gosh, I'm gonna have to make some more tinder plugs. TBH. Alright, hold the phone. This doesn't work. I'm gonna have to use the accelerant, probably. Either that or I'm gonna have to drop a lot of stuff, and I don't know if things will cure right here. I doubt it. I think I tried that before. Firewood. Some sticks. Before it gets too dark, I guess I'll take a peek. Screw myself. I'm gonna need some firewood. I didn't grab that coal. Over here is a fir limb. That'll help out considerably. Some more sticks. I'm about to make more tinder plugs. can't wait to drop these pelts off so I can move this fast all the time. I know you guys are like, so tired of this dude, like, walking around overweight. I'm like, me too. Me too. But we gotta carry the stuff. Look at all this stuff I piled up. Oh my gosh. Alright, so. Let's go ahead and have us something to eat. Bring up some of that weight. Oh yeah. 43 minutes. It's probably enough time to read an hour of this new book. We found us a new book. Only got 5 hours on it, but like, it's about revolvers. It's pretty much all we have, so why not? Alright. I think we're just gonna turn in for the night. Be able to sleep that much. Oh, it's another Aurora tonight. Cool. Well, then I might be able to just read my book. Water. Oh, it didn't even boil all the way. What the heck? Well, I'll wait till in the morning. Because then I can at least make, like, some hot food for us to head out in. This book that I don't have to carry it around anymore. At least I can use it for the fire in the morning. Alright, how many? Let's go ahead and craft us some tinder plugs. Alright guys, I'm gonna go grab some more coffee. That's gonna be it for this one. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.